Good morning. On the 11th hour of the 11th day of the 11th month in 1918, the First World War ended. Civilians wanted to remember the people who had given their lives for peace. The 2-minute silence is observed at this time of the day each year. Whatever the moral ambiguity of any war, remembrance transcends all boundaries. The silence is a small yet important individual and collective act. A rare moment when the nation can stand together and reflect on the price of freedom. This year, the act of remembrance is all the more poignant because of the loss taking place around us. The pandemic gives us a small indication of what any wartime situation must be like. Pain of suffering, the helplessness of not knowing how long something is going to last and what the human toll will be, both in terms of lives cut short and lives which cannot be lived to the full. But also the heroism on the part of some individuals doing their bit to fight the enemy. That heroism today, as in any war, is on the part of medics looking after the ill and the dying, of women and men who are seeking a scientific solution, on those who are keeping the supply chains going, and on the soldiers who are on the front line, this time supervising COVID testing and building Nightingale hospitals, rather than taking part in bloodier battles. For all of us, it is important to be brave, to support one another, and to be resilient, confident that we shall see things through and experience a normal life again, however long it takes to get there. Our first hymn, however, makes some sense of life after death. Its words were redrafted by their original author in 1918 and refer to the sacrifice of those who died during the First World War, as well as reminding us of a world beyond this life, whose ways are ways of pleasantness, and where all have paths of peace. The poem was set to music by Gustav Holst in the 20s and became a common element at Armistice memorial ceremonies. So please stand and listen to hymn 42, I Vow to Thee My Country. If you wish to join in by humming or singing the words softly, please do so. Matter what assails us. So today's readings are about hope. Please sit for a poetry reading from Khadija and then Hannah, in which
Hope is a Tattered Flag by Carl Sandburg. Hope is a tattered flag in a dream of time. Hope is a heartsman word, the rainbow, the shackle of light, the evening star, inviolable over the whole lines, the shimmer of northern lights across a bitter winter night, the blue hills beyond the smoke of the steelworks, the birds who go on singing to their mates in peace. The 10-cent crocus bulb blooming in a used car salesman. The horseshoe over the door. The luck piece in the pocket. The kiss and the comforting love and resolve. Hope is an echo. Hope ties itself. Yonder, yonder.
The spring grass showing itself where least expected. The roaming flock of white clouds on a changeless sky. The broadcast of strings from Japan, bells from Moscow, of the voice of the Prime Minister of Sweden carried across the sea in behalf of the world family of nations, and children singing carols of the Christ Child, and bark being broadcast from Bethlehem, Pennsylvania, and tall skyscrapers practically empty of tenants, and the hands of strong men groping for handfuls, and the Salvation Army singing.
Thank you, girls. And then Molly is going to read the second poem.
Hope is the thing with feathers by Emily Dickinson. Hope is the thing with feathers that perches in the soul and sings the tune without the words and never stops at all. The sweetest in the gale is heard, and sore must be the storm that could abash the little bird that kept so many warm. I've heard it in the chillest land and on the strangest sea, yet never in extremity it asked a crumb of me.
The Ode of Remembrance is an ode taken from Laurence Binyon's poem For the Fallen. It was first published in the Times in September 1914. It is said on occasions like these, and the last line is repeated by the congregation. So please, when I finish, please say the last line after I have said it. They went with songs to the battle. They were young, straight of limb, true of eyes, steady and aglow. They were staunched to the end against odds uncounted. They fell with their faces to the foe. They shall grow not old, as weavers are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun and in the morning, we will remember them.
We will remember them.
Thank you.
And mutual benefit rather than revenge, while seeking maximum personal corporate gain. When justice and equality before the law become the basis of the government, when basic freedoms exist, when leaders, political, religious, educational, and the police and media wholeheartedly embrace the concepts of justice, equality, freedom, tolerance, and reconciliation as a basis for renewal. When parents teach their children new ways to think about people, there will be peace when enemies become fellow human beings.
And now we're going to listen to Hannah play the clarinet. Come together today, citizens of earth and of heaven, to remember with pride and appreciation those who have given their lives in service of others, to remember with dismay the suffering, destruction, and pain caused by human conflict, to remember with gratitude those whose lives, love, and friendship ask for being the privilege to share. To remember with sadness those whose death has caused us loneliness and pain. We come together not to glorify or celebrate the war in conflict, but to recognise its cost and commit ourselves to be peacemakers and peacekeepers wherever that opportunity falls within our grasp. And in our remembrance, we give God thanks for memory itself, through which we are forever warmed by the mistakes of the past and enriched by experiences that can no longer be known in the present. Amen. Please remain standing and listen to hymn number 8. Please hum or sing along quietly if you wish to.
Thank you very much. Please go through.